So for this decontamination laundry room, we actually have an exhaust fan and a makeup air louver in the wall. So we've got the exhaust fan operating, but we don't have any way for the energy model to know where to get makeup air. So really the exhaust fan is probably just exhausting any infiltration to the room. Let's go back to our OpenStudio model. And let's go to thermal zones. Thermal zone 102, we have the exhaust fan, and we did hard size it for 152 CFM. And just for curiosity, let's take a look at what the infiltration is for that room. If we go to the EnergyPlus results, table of contents, and outdoor air system, we can look at the infiltration rate for this room, which is approximately 10 CFM. So that exhaust fan is for this energy model, that exhaust fan is just exhausting 10 CFM. The energy model is not smart enough to balance airflows. So for that, we have to balance those. Let's go back to the space types tab. And our laundry room, decontamination room, space type here. We're going to have to edit this infiltration flow rate. And we'll change the design flow rate calculation method to flow per space. And this will be the same value as what that exhaust fan is exhausting, 152 CFM. And we will delete this flow per surface area. And then there's some other coefficients in here that you can apply based on what type of infiltration you're doing. These won't be applicable to us because we're just focusing on ensuring that the infiltration rate is equal to that exhaust fan. But if you are doing a different infiltration calculation that's sensitive to exterior conditions such as temperature and wind velocity, you might look at these coefficients, and you can go to this link here and download a PDF document that it goes into a lot more detail on these. And these coefficients are used to modify your simulation. Essentially, the default coefficients that are in EnergyPlus and OpenStudio is a coefficient of 1, and all the rest are 0. So EnergyPlus and OpenStudio are effectively canceling out all of the temperature difference and wind speed differences, and strictly designing infiltration based on a schedule. So if you do have a building that's sensitive to infiltration based on wind speed and temperature differences, you're probably going to want to change those constants. So we've got our infiltration rate adjusted. One other thing I want to mention is if you do have several different laundry rooms in your building, you might want to change those. You might have to customize each one of those laundry rooms. You might have to create a new space type for each one of those laundry rooms based on that infiltration flow rate value that we just inputted to match the exhaust fan. And that, the next, let's go to loads, and we'll look at our laundry room, decontamination room. Infiltration is based on this laundry infiltration schedule here that's already inside our model. So we will take a look at that schedule on Schedules tab. Here. And you can see that infiltration rate turns higher during the daytime. And that is probably based on our occupancy schedule, which is from 8 a.m. to 5 p.m. And you can see it goes lower during the nighttime. Our default design is 100%. So we want to make sure that that's at 100% for summer and winter for sizing the zone equipment or the HVAC equipment. But looking at our schedule, so during the occupied hours, it goes to 100%. So that makes sure that ensures that the infiltration flow will be 152 CFM during occupied hours. And then in the evening, when that exhaust fan shuts off, it should go back down to the default, which we calculated as 10 CFM. And that equates to approximately 0.07% of full airflow. So we need to adjust those down for the nighttime hours just to reflect typical infiltration values. And we will save the model and go ahead and run it. And we will go to the results summary tab and open up DView. Actually, let's take a look at zone conditions. Okay, you can see that our unmet hours during the high temperatures have dropped significantly, and the zone temperatures have coalesced into the low 70s. So let's go to DView. And then let's go to Daily tab. And we will select outdoor dry bulb temperature and zone temperature. Okay. So it looks like this has solved a lot of our problems. During the wintertime, you can see that the space temperature maintains a pretty steady 70 degrees now, and we're not having those overheating problems. The temperatures do climb during the summertime, but that's to be expected, especially in a laundry room where we don't have any active cooling systems maintaining those temperatures. So it looks pretty reasonable. That's all for balancing airflows, makeup air for exhaust fans. Thank you. Please like and subscribe.